Hi students, good morning to all of you and welcome to online class. Students, today I will come with one important and beautiful lesson, that is healthy eating habits. This is the subunit of in unit 4, healthy eating habits. And did you know, students, all living things need food? Yes. So all living things need food, and man is omnivorous. Omnivorous means man is eat both flesh and as well as grass eating animals. So man is omnivorous. We eat all the types of food. So we need all the different types of food. And one more question I am asking you, student. What does the food do? If we are eating the food, why we are eating? Because the food gives us energy and it helps us to grow and it keeps us healthy. That's why we are eating food. And one more important factor is there, student, that is kinds of food. This is the very important about your next coming exam. Very important. So students, in our daily life, we are eating different types of food. In this food, having many kinds of foods are there. Kinds of food means different types of foods. Basically, there are four kinds of foods are there. So one is carbohydrate, second one is the protein, and third one is the fats, fourth one is the vitamins and minerals. Just look, be careful, student. These are the four kinds of food. So in next coming exam, if suppose they are asking, write the kinds of food. So you have to write this like only carbohydrate, protein, fat, vitamins and mineral. These are the kinds of food. Now let's come, we shall discussing one by one how whole detail explanation. First one, carbohydrate. It's a one kinds of food. And this carbohydrate food, it contains starch or sugar. It contains starch or rich sugar in the food, and very good quality food, and it having more content of starch. And one more also, this carbohydrate provide energy to the body. Carbohydrate food are there. They are provide energy to the body. That's why these carbohydrate also called energy giving food. Why their carbohydrate called energy giving food? Because carbohydrate provide the energy to our body. That's why carbohydrate are called also energy giving food. And what are their carbohydrates examples? Here is the rice, idli, chapati and potato. Not only these, so many are there. Just I am writing only the sum only. Okay. So these are the examples of carbohydrate. Next one, protein. Protein, these are the, this is also one kinds of food, and this protein help us to grow. What? Protein help us to grow. Keep in your mind, this is very important word. Protein help us to grow, and protein also help repair our body and replace their worn out tissues. And growing children recovering from illness need more proteins than the other. Basically, children have need more amount of protein food. That's why, mind, even also illness people also have need more protein. Why? Because this protein foods are their bodybuilding food. If you are eating rich amount of protein food, your body becomes very healthy. That's why proteins are bodybuilding food. Examples for protein is milk, fish and egg. Many are there. Here I write only three. Milk, fish and egg are the examples of protein food. Next come to third one, fats. Fats is also called lipid because fats food having rich amount of energy. They having so much lipid in the food. And these fats have giving energy to our body and keeps it warm also. Compared to carbohydrate and fats, fats foods are there more energy to our body. More energy to our body means what? Fats give us more energy to our body and it also keeps warm. And In basically pads food are eating who have living in the cold country need more pad rich foods people living in the warmer nation. So that's why these pads are very important. Examples for pads: cake, oil and ghee. These are the examples of pad food. And last one, vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals is also called protective food. These are the very special kind of food in. These are the very special kind of food. Why? Because these are called protective food. Means what? These help us to fight the disease and stay healthy. Who have eat more vitamins and minerals food, they have stay very healthy. And if there any type of diseases come to their body, that these protective foods or these vitamin and mineral food to help us to fight the disease and stay healthy. That's why you have to eat more vitamins and mineral food. Examples of vitamins and minerals: all fruits, fenugreek, and basically vegetables and pea. Pea is also there. Examples of vitamins and mineral. And vitamins and minerals is also called protective food. Keep in your mind. So these are the kinds of food, students. I hope you are understood this one. And one more thing is there. I will give two important points to you. That is very important. You have to keep in your mind. The first one, 2/3 of our body is made up of water. Whole our body is there. We have to divide three parts. Just you imagine, divide three parts means don't think there in the negative way. Okay, think positive. Just you imagine, if our whole body have to divide three parts, out of three, two parts are made up of water. The remaining one part is tissues, cells, bones, etc. So that's why our whole body is maximum is made up of water. And even our brain is also there. Brain is 70% of water. It contains 70% of water. Remaining 30% other things, cells, other parts of brains are there. So maximum 70% of water is there. So keep in your mind. Why I am telling to you, this is a general knowledge. You have to just keep in your mind. Whenever they are asking, you have to tell. Okay, I hope you are understood this one lesson, because this is very important to our next coming exam and even also the general purpose also. Okay, I hope you are understood this one. Have a nice day. Bye.